after purification of the environment, which is a seemingly impossible job, if you accomplished it, or even if a tiny bit of it is improved, you can now take a look at the body, which is the next higher layer in our layered structure that we are experiencing right now. The body can get many impurities. The list is going to be very long, and I'm not going to be very exhaustive about it. I'm just going to give you some examples. And it is not that everybody has all these impurities. You may have a few of them. And it is slightly easier than the environment because you have a bit of control over the body. Not a lot, but a bit. Remember, the body is not you. But for the purpose of our talk, I'm going to call the body as you simply because it is convenient. And that is what a person is going to think initially. Even a seeker is going to think that I am the body till there appears this knowledge of being a nobody. And the body is not mine. There is nobody that owns it. So now the question comes, why should I take this trouble of purifying the body? If it is not mine, if it is not me, if it is an illusion, why should I worry about it? There are two answers to this, that there is nobody to fix the impurities. First of all, you are always a witness with impurities, without impurities, not trying to fix it or trying to fix it. So whatever happens, happens out of absolute necessity. This question should not arise that why I should do it, because there is no I. It is the body. And the second answer is, the body has its own intelligence. It purifies itself. And many people must have noticed this. Just like any other layer, it has its own processes. So all you need to do is, don't make it impure. That's all. It is going to take care of itself. Due to our ignorance, we make it impure. The body has sufficient arrangements to keep itself pure. You can take a look at Mother Nature. The animals are beautiful, except some of them. The birds are beautiful. Even the insects are very, very clean. As long as they are in the natural environment, they do not cause any kind of impurities in their bodies. There are some creatures, for example, bats or rats or pigeons. They are extremely filthy. There are always some exceptions. I don't know whether they perceive it like that. And I don't know where are we going to place humans in that two categories of filthy animals and clean animals. We are in both, I think. So all we need to do is utilize this natural ability of the bodies to remain pure. Don't break that process and you don't have to do anything after that. It is not me, it is not mine, but it is the current experience, and we want this experience to be pleasant. We have this desire to have a good experience of the body. As long as you have a body, there will be this responsibility of it. As intelligent creatures, we need to accept this experience. Accept your body. Call it me, call it mine. It's all okay. It's for practical purposes. Forget about the truth when it comes to impurities. The truth is your current experience. Oh no, I'm a spiritual person. I cannot be attached to the body. I cannot take care of it because I'm not it. I'll just go and sit in the cave. This is some kind of resistance. This is some kind of escape from the experience of the body. Yes, that is true that one day you will be freed from the body and you are in a hurry. Yes, we know that. But right now, right here, we are stuck with it. Till you progress beyond human and you get some other body, probably a light body, a magical body, a rainbow body, we are stuck with this body. Now we have two options, either discard it or make use of it. And any intelligent seeker is going to take the second option. Okay, I have it now. Let me use it. It is my vehicle. My vehicle to experience the illusion, to learn. As soon as we decide this, it becomes our job to maintain the body. Not too much, just a bit. Remember, the body maintains itself. So our job is very easy. Don't break it. It's very simple. Don't be stupid. So I'm going to give you a long list of impurities here, and you will find that most of them are inflicted on the body because of ignorance of the person, because of this holder of the body. The vehicle is super smart, but the user is dumb, does not know how to drive it. The user is deluded, thinking that I drive it, I'll do whatever I want with it. And that is the impurity. I told you, ignorance is the basic impurity here. The environment, the bodies, the minds, they do not really cause problems. Naturally, the user is the problem. Like we say in the IT, that the problem is between monitor and keyboard. There is no other problem. The system is perfect. What is a body? The body is an ecosystem of tiny organisms that have decided to cooperate to form a complex structure. It is made up of human cells, bacteria, viruses, microbes, fungus, parasites, and 1,000 kinds of chemicals that flow in and out of it. I told you that the earth is our part. This matter that enters the body comes from the ecosystem that is outside, and then it flows back into the environment. What happens in between is shocking. It is a tiny environment in itself. The body is an ecosystem in itself. It is also very complex. 70 to 80% of the cells or the organisms that make up the body are non-human. They are creatures living on the so-called human body. There is no human body actually. Just a system of organs and other creatures. If that does not cause detachment with the body, then I don't know what will cause. You can see that those who call the body as me must be under some kind of hypnotic influence. Those who are attached to the body, I highly recommend visiting a medical college where they cut the body down and put the different sections of the body in glass bottles, in formaldehyde. I'm pretty sure that your attachment will evaporate in one day because this happened to me. Now it looks like a machine. It's no more me. That one experience changed me forever. Learn about the body. Learn the biology. This is the path of knowledge. You need to learn everything. That knowledge will not be wasted. That knowledge can be used to remove the impurities of the body. And as a bonus, it causes detachment. There is a difference between detachment and indifference. Indifference is unhealthy. It is a repulsion. Detachment is healthy. It is acceptance. Fully knowing what it is, you accept it. Accept the machine. Keep it working. This is what is our ticket outside the illusion of the physical world. Use it. It works best if it is kept pure in a working condition. It's not going to last, but that is not our goal. We don't want to make it last. We just want to make it serve us nicely as long as it is there. It's very easy, very simple goal here. Don't need to make it immortal or the most beautiful diamond-studded thing. Our goal is very simple. Don't break it. That's all. That is all we need to ensure. I told you, this is simpler than the environment thing, which is kind of horrible. Body is the part of the environment and the body contributes in polluting the environment. Let us take a look at the impurities. The body continuously exchanges all kinds of matter with the environment. There are 9 or 10 orifices in the body. You can count them in your free time. That is interesting. And these orifices continuously ooze out sticky substances in the environment. That is why I said that it contributes in making the environment dirty. If it is not cleaned from the outside, it will become filthy and it will make everything else filthy. Its surroundings will become filthy. And it is actually not right that it has 9 or 10 holes in it. There are millions of holes. That's what we call a skin. The skin oozes out the sweat, oil, who knows what. Even our breathing is actually polluting the environment. We breathe out carbon dioxide. Mother Nature takes care of this kind of holy thing by various means, which I don't want to explain right now, but other microbes, they contribute in cleaning it up somehow. That causes body odor. The microbes are breaking down all this organic matter that comes out of this body. The impurity here is that because humans are living outside their natural environment, they're not in contact with nature anymore, they're living an artificial life, they need to clean it. And if that is not done regularly, the body becomes filthy. Another thing humans do is that they wear clothes. It can be due to necessity because we don't have protection from the heat and cold. Because again, we are not living in our natural habitats. Other animals, they don't need to do that. They are under protection by natural means. Whether it is fur, whether it is feather, humans don't have anything. They are bare. So we invented clothing. And it has become an impurity in itself because the body makes the clothes dirty. Now you will need to wash them. Another impurity is that if the clothing is not according to the weather, it causes discomfort in the body. People wear heavy clothes in a warm climate. People wear clothes that stop the perspiration from evaporating. The clothes accumulate microbes. So unclean clothes, improper clothes. It is a good thing to wash everything, but people use chemicals to wash the clothes and the body. They use chemicals that kill 95% of the germs, as they claim on the TV. Now that is sometimes important when you are in surroundings like hospitals and so on. But if you use them every day, then it causes problems. I've seen people use the antibacterial detergents to clean their clothes. That is a problem. Because the body learns to fight the germs by coming in contact with those germs, bacteria and viruses and whatnot. When you don't provide them with these naturally occurring life forms, it forgets to protect itself. It becomes lazy. That is called immune disorder, technically, because it is not getting exposed to its natural enemies. The immunity drops, and if you don't wash it for one day, it becomes sick. Using chemicals simply disturbs the natural balance of the body, which it has so painstakingly built up since the body was little. The immune system takes many years to mature, and you can mess it up completely simply by using chemicals to kill everything in this ecosystem. Remember, there are bacteria on the skin. Like, it is totally covered with a layer of bacteria. If you kill most of them, the job of decomposing the dead skin, decomposing whatever comes out of the holes in the skin, stops. That gives a chance to for the harmful germs to take over. So using chemicals to clean the body is an impurity. You think I'm cleaning it, you are actually making it worse. Some people use makeup, a lot of it. They block the pores of the body, of the skin. Now it cannot excrete all that stuff. It kills the good bacteria on the skin. It exposes in the skin to chemicals which are in them, the makeup kit, the dyes and the powders and who knows what. Some people have opened a chemist shop on their dressing table. There are so many chemicals there. It is horrifying to see it. And they spend 1 hour every day to turn their face into something which it is not. Now you can see that the impurity here is not only on the body, it is also in the mind. There is an inferiority complex there which tells them that if I don't look in a specific way, people are not going to love me. People are not going to accept me. People are going to make fun of me. And this impurity is in the mind that translates into impurity on the body. This is one aspect of torturing the body with chemicals and different colors and so on. There are many aspects of makeup. For example, people color their hair to look younger. Here, there is a fear that people are not going to accept me if I am old, or they are trying to be young again, or they are so afraid of old age that they are deluding themselves thinking that I am still young. They don't want to see white hair on their body. You can see the many mental abnormalities here, including attachment with the body, that I am the body and I need to look in a specific way. Some people are trying to show off. Some people, it is their job to look good, so they overdo it. And there are some people who are ugly and they want to hide their ugliness because there is nothing else in their life except a face, except a body. They want to hide that if it is ugly. And there is some social effect here also, that people don't like ugly people, even if they are good people. So that deformity in the mind and society shows up in the form of a layer of chemicals on the face, color in the hair, and so on. People are filthy, and if they start smelling, they start using deodorants and perfumes of various kinds. It is not bad, but if you do it every day, it is an impurity. It causes damage. And hiding the filth is not really purification. Wash it off, and whatever is the natural smell of the body, it is beautiful. Like, who knows what it is, but we are programmed to perceive it as good. But we are also programmed to be fooled by perfumes and deodorants. That is why they work. They do not work because they clean the body. They work because they fool other people into thinking that since you are smelling good, you must be clean. It is opposite. You needed that chemical on your skin because you are filthy. The body smells nice when it is clean. And when it starts smelling bad, that is also good because that is a natural signal that it needs cleaning. People hide this. If you need a ton of makeup every day to keep your relationship on, then you are in a wrong relationship. Some people, they are not satisfied with chemicals. They make more holes in the body. That's called piercing. Wherever there is a place they find, wherever it does not kill them, they make holes there and put metals into that. Now, I know this is very old-fashioned, like the tribal people used to, like many million years, many, many thousand years ago, the cave people, they used to pierce their bodies and put bones and whatever they found around them. They used to put those things inside, those holes. I don't know why. Somehow it makes them attractive, it looks like, but any seeker will find it disgusting that the body that is already so dirty has holes in it and things are dangling from those holes. Like, I find it very, very funny. Yes, you can wear those metal and dangling things on the body. Nobody stops you. But do not make holes in the body, you see. That is an impurity. And that is also connected to the inferiority complex, that I'm not good enough as this. First of all, I'm the body and I'm not good enough. I need to make holes in my body and put metal in that to become acceptable, to show off something which I am not. This is a big impurity and the body suffers. Now we go to the really important part, which is food. We are alive because of the food. And people eat rancid, very heavy food. They overeat and they eat food made outside by other people. And they eat food made in factory. They do not cook it themselves. They do not know what to eat and they do not know how to eat, how much to eat. This is really strange because no other animal does that. From an insect to an ape, everybody knows what to eat. Humans don't. And it is not because we don't have that instinct. It is because humans are ignorant. They are stupid. Or they think I'm smart, but whatever they do is really stupid. People eat things that make them sick, that make them fat, ugly, diseased, and smelly. Whatever you eat comes out of the body in the form of filth. People kill animals. People eat the dead bodies of the animals and get all the filth that the animal had, all the parasites, all the chemicals that the body of that animal produces, all the bacteria and viruses. And the body is very tolerant. The body is very resilient. It fights. But then it is always in the fighting mode. After every dinner and lunch, it goes on a war with whatever you have eaten. It tries to clean it. It can do that because, you see, we have evolved to eat almost anything. That is another problem. We don't know what to eat because this body can digest almost everything. The problem is, we don't know not to do that. There are good times when we should eat only human food. There are bad times when we should eat whatever we find. This is how this thing has evolved. The problem is, we are living in a relatively good time where there is abundance of food and we still eat the filth which the body is kind of programmed to tolerate somehow. That includes dead animals. Whatever people eat is just impurity, and it causes many more impurities in turn. Some wise men have said that we are that which we eat. Food is kind of very important thing for the body. If you don't provide it with nice food, it becomes impure very quickly. Similarly for drinks, people drink sugar-rated drinks. The body is not designed to tolerate it. The body wants simple, pure water. By pure, I mean natural water, not distilled water. People drink carbonized drinks for some reason, for fun probably. That causes impurities in the body. People drink chemical soups because sugar and carbon is not enough. I need to abuse the body more. Some kind of chemical soups, dark liquids, which also have sugar and carbon in them, plus chemicals. That's what I need to do to appear cool, as they show on the TV. That's how smart I am. And people drink alcohol, which is probably the biggest impurity when it comes to drinking. The alcohol damages the whole body. It damages the brain, damages the nervous system, and it totally destroys the intellect. And the drugs fall in the same category. People abuse their bodies and minds using alcohol and drugs. When I said people are stupid, it was an understatement. A thing that needs just pure water, look what you have done to it. How much the body has been abused, for what, I don't know. Such a body becomes diseased, then dies. The pleasure that you think is pleasure is actually invitation to death. The pleasure is not bad. Yes, you should have some pleasure, but this is abuse. This is not pleasure. Similarly, about the air, we discussed already that people breathe polluted air, they breathe smoke, they breathe the smog, or they breathe the stale air because they live in a closed cabin, which they call my house, my home. They live in artificial air-conditioned system places where the same air passes through the whole room again and again for many days because it is too risky to open the door because all the bad air will come in. And they breathe the humid air which contains all these pores of fungus and so on. It smells bad and it causes impurities in the body. It causes airborne diseases. Next is the sleep. And sleep is something which cannot be controlled. It is automated. But people misuse that also. Some sleep a lot. Some barely sleep. They're trying to control their sleep. Because I want to work more. Why? I want to earn more money. The other person has more money. He does not sleep. And I want to become like that. People sleep in an untimely way. The body cannot take it after a few years. It gives up. The body has its own way of complaining. Everybody knows that. There is something else which is not in our voluntary control, and that is defecation. The body needs to throw away that which is undigested, or the impurities inside the body itself, the blood and all, needs to be cleaned. And people cause trouble in that process also. They either hold it or they eat so much that they need to do it every now and then. Or they don't do it for many days sometimes. That causes accumulation of poisons in the body and the body falls sick. It also becomes ugly. It also becomes smelly. And the same impurities they start appearing on the skin. Irregular defecation has consequences that are too big to mention here. Nobody likes to discuss this matter because everybody knows it is bad. Everybody knows it is obscene discussion. But for a seeker, it is very important. I'm giving you a guarantee that if your defecation is not proper, you won't progress on your spiritual path. This is the natural process that the body employs to clean itself. And if you interfere in that, the body will not cooperate. It will cause you to regress on your whatever you're doing. Not only spiritual practices, your job will suffer, your relations will suffer, whatever you do will fail most of the time. The defecation process controls even the higher layers such as intellect and all. If you don't believe me, you should try the little experiments. Don't do it, hold it, and so on. You will know what I mean. You can control your hunger for a while, but you cannot control the defecation. And it should not be controlled. The problem is people try to force it at a specific time, or they want to delay it for some reason. Mental conditions like too much fear and anxiety also causes the body to stop defecating, or it does not do it properly. And people have bad habits, and people have kind of childish behavior. They do not wash themselves properly. They do not wash their hands. They don't have toilet manners. They do it anywhere they want. Defecation, a dirty process. Why should I build a room in my house to do it? I'll just go and do somewhere else. Some people, they cannot squat properly. And I can understand that happens with age. And they do not empty themselves properly. Because almost sitting or standing, half standing, that pose is not good enough. Because of their eating habits and drinking habits, either they cannot totally defecate. If they drink too little, well, the diseases like kidney stones and all these diseases, they start appearing. Remember, the body is essentially a food pipe around which some organs have grown. There are only two ends to this food pipe. You have already made one end impure, and now the other end is also suffering. If people cannot take care of a food pipe, what else can you expect? The body builds up its stamina through exercising. It needs to run, it needs to walk, it needs to lift weight, it needs to jump. And if you don't do all these things, the muscles, they start becoming weak. They atrophy. The bones become brittle and weak. The range of motion suffers. Remember, the body is born perfect. You can look at the children. They don't go to gym. They don't train with anybody. And they can do anything they want. The whole day they are active. But as they grow up, they accumulate impurities and they stop exercising. And now the body loses all these abilities. The body becomes ugly, weak, deformed because of lack of exercises. Some people overexert. Probably their job is like that. Probably they need to dig ditches or something like that. Move the stones. Highly laborious jobs. And that also causes problems for the body because the body has a limit. It cannot do more than a specific kind of exercise. Just enough exercise keeps it fit and healthy and strong. You overdo it and then it suffers. Probably overdoing is not a big problem, but not doing it is the modern problem. People don't exercise. The bodies become ugly, the bodies become fat, the bodies become diseased, weak. This is a major impurity. And I've seen this happen since childhood nowadays. Even children, they don't do their regular exercises. Now we should note here that after a certain age, the exercises, they work in reverse. After a certain age, the body needs rest, not exercise. And if you do it in that age, it causes problems for the body. So people don't know when to do it, how much to do it, when to stop it. People don't know even how to sit properly because we do not sit in a natural way. We have invented things like chairs or sofas or the car seat or these days the computer chair where we sit for many, many hours and the posture causes problem because this is not the natural way to sit. I don't think anybody knows what is the natural way to sit. So the posture is not ergonomic and people do repetitive work in that posture, especially nowadays. We work on computers that causes repetitive stress injuries in the body, in the back pain, in the spinal problems, and the nerve pain in the hands or diseases of the bones and joints. They are because of wrong posture. It is the impurity. Now, probably everybody knows it, but nobody knows how to treat it. Actually, there is no treatment for it. The body is a strange thing, actually. It produces a bit of pleasure, a sensation which it likes whenever its demands are met, whenever it survives successfully. Whether it is food, whether it is defecation, whether it is exercise, or whether it is sex, whatever is useful for survival, it produces a reward for it. That is what we call pleasure. And people, they want this pleasure. Actually, that's what most of them are alive, to get the pleasure somehow. The body generates the pleasure and they want to do it again and again. And it is okay, it is a natural process, but it becomes an impurity when people try to do it artificially, or they try to do it too much, because the pleasure plateaus after a while. Like, you cannot have infinite amount of it. After a while, it becomes no pleasure. And then if you continue, it becomes pain. In order to produce this impulse of pleasure, people do all kinds of stupid things. That is called addiction. It can be sugar, it can be tea or coffee, it can be smoking, it can be alcohol, it can be drugs, it can be sex, it can be movies. Whatever gives them a little bit of pleasure, people get addicted to it. It can be games, or it can be something really, really stupid like gossip, reading newspapers and things like that. That is the abuse of this pleasure-causing mechanism in the body. A major impurity in the body is the disease that is well known. I need not say too much about it. There can be many reasons the diseases appear in the body. Some of them are natural, some of them are infectious, and some of them are unnatural. They are inflicted on the body. But you will find a common thing in the diseases, that they are mostly caused by some kind of imbalance. The body has built-in mechanism to defend from diseases, but our lifestyle, the human lifestyle, causes imbalance in this defense mechanism that causes disease. This is a big subject. I'm not going to go into details of it. I mean, the causes can be physical to mental to social, anything. Then a big impurity in the body is deformation. The deformation is abnormal formation of the body parts, or absence of the body parts. So it can be genetic, it can be due to accidents, it can be anything. But for the purpose of spiritual work, we count it as an impurity. It causes trouble in spiritual work, especially if your path involves manipulating the body. And deformation also affects the mind by causing a sense of inferiority in that person. The next one is the disability. What is the difference? A disability is not deformation. The parts are there, intact, but they are not working. For example, blindness, deafness, or the inability to digest some kind of foods and so on. They are all forms of disabilities. And they also cause trouble in spiritual undertakings. Not only spiritual, actually. This, you can see, is a general talk. They cause a low quality of life. So these three things, disease, deformation, and disability, they form a part of the dreaded 4 Ds. Which one is fourth? Death. These 4 Ds, everybody is afraid of. I'm not including death in the impurities. Obviously, that's not really needed. It is not an impurity. It is the end of impurities. So anyhow, as the body grows old, it develops its own problems. Everybody knows that. These are the old age problems. It becomes weak. It loses its defense mechanisms. It loses its power to digest food. And all other bodily functions, they degrade, including loss of intellect. Everything suffers, including sleep, defecation, posture, inability to exercise. Disabilities, they start accumulating. This is body saying bye-bye. I don't know whether I should include it into impurities or not, but people make their old age even more difficult by doing stupid things. Like, they try to extend the age of the body using medicines or who knows what. Or they try to appear young, as I said. They try to eat the same food which they ate in their young age. That's not possible now. Or they try to work in the same way for long hours, thinking that I am not old, or it is bad to be old. Like, the problem is also social. Like, people think it is inferior to be old. I don't know how that happened. It's a mental disease of some kind. I have seen that if I call somebody old, they get offended. It's not bad to be old. It is kind of mental retardation to be offended when you think you are young. There has to be some social reason for it. Probably it's an imported belief, because in this culture, it was not wrong to be old. Never. Old people got more respect and care and love. I don't know what happened. Now it is a crime to be old. And it has become a social kind of bad manners to call somebody old. We lie to that person. Oh, you look young today. The old age is seen as an impurity. And it actually, people have turned it into an impurity. Now, this is just one body. This is me. The other people are also cause of impurities in this body. Why? Because there is no separation with other people. We bump into other people. Like, we live in crowded places, as we discussed. We share the same things. If you go to a restaurant, you are served food. The plate was used by 100 other people before you. The spoons went into 200 more mouths before they entered your mouth. You are sitting in a table and chair that was used by hundreds of people. It was not cleaned in between. The other people cause impurities in you. You don't see it because there is some kind of blindness to this thing. We are not supposed to do this. You sit on the same toilet on which 1,000 other people sit. This is the daily routine, especially in cities. You sit in the same train and bus. You hold the same door handles and supports. You never wash your hands. You never take a bath when you come home from outside. Your shoes accumulate the same disease every time you go out. People spit on the floor. They spit on the roads. They urinate and everywhere, and you walk on that. In the villages, there is cow dung everywhere. There is pee everywhere. There is filth everywhere. You walk on that. You bring it all in your house. Some people have jobs that make them sit and talk to hundreds of people every day. Like, they expose themselves to hundreds of people every day. If you are a ticket checker, if you are in a bank where you interact with people, if you are sitting in any place where there is no proper separation, there is no, you are not behind a glass or something like that, you will be exposed to hundreds of people every day. These other people cause problems in your body. Other people are also indirectly responsible for problems of the body, because we watch other people and we acquire their habits, bad habits, good habits. For example, the children are going to copy whatever the adults are doing, and the teenagers copy whatever any idiot is doing on the TV. So even when they are intelligent, even when they are pure, they acquire the impurities from other people. Now, there is something big which is the cause of big impurity in the body, and that is the war and crime. It is not enough to be full of all these impurities. People cause damage to the bodies by fighting. They do not like other bodies, so they kill them. They mutilate them. They rape them. They beat them up. They torture other bodies. They call themselves humans for some reason. How can somebody who is engaged in war and crime be a human? So violence and causing harm to the body is big impurity, which is also found in monkeys, for example. Animals do fight sometimes, but war is something which is an achievement of the humanity. Millions of people, they become disabled, they become deformed, and because of the biological weapons or chemical weapons or who knows what they are using these days to kill people, their lives become hell. Your life is your body. It is very easy to see it. And if there is no war, if there is no crime, people are too stupid to drive carelessly, to do all kinds of stupid adventures, or they engage in sports that is kind of very risky. and they cause permanent damage to their bodies. Now, we can forget about the spiritual things here. Even the normal life becomes hellish. The list is very long. I can go on and on for many hours like this. Remember what people have done to their bodies. Realize this, that they have gone to such lengths to make this very beautiful instrument the worst possible thing in the universe. And they call them intelligent species for some great reason. Have you seen any bigger joke than this one? You thought that the problems of the environment that we discussed, they point to some very big mental degradation in humans. After going through this list, tell me, what do you think? Can we call humans intelligent? Can we even call them ignorant? Why will an ignorant person do this thing to their own bodies? Not only one or two, 99% people do these things to their bodies. Have you thought about it? Sit down one day and think, is this some kind of big mental disease? Are we in a hell where people have lost their humanity? Are we in a lower world where these tormented souls, these lost creatures are piled up? Think, why are you here? Why are you in this so-called human society? They call themselves civilized and so on. You see, big names. Probably they are trying to hide their guilt. No, look at me. I'm great. I'm superior. Because look at all the gold that I'm stuffing in all my holes. Look at the expensive clothes. It is 40 degrees outside and I'm in a imported expensive suit. I don't think they know. I don't think they know what they do. Only those whose eyes are open, only those who have a little bit of light in them, they can see what is going on here. And I urge you to open your eyes. Start purifying your body. So we are going to go in very short. How to fix this system? How to fix this madness? Remember, there is nothing wrong in the body. These things are done to it. So just don't do it. Very easy. You don't need to listen to me further. Those who are interested, they can. I think you already know what not to do. Take care of all the holes in the body. Keep washing it. Wear the clothes according to the weather, not according to the fashion. Not to show off how superior you are. If it is 40 degrees outside, you need to be in very clean cotton clothing, loose clothing, flowing clothing. Yes, if you are an Eskimo, you need to be covered in reindeer skin or bear skin or whatever. Wash the clothes. Do not use chemicals. Keep your immunity up. You don't want your room to become surgically clean, like an operation theater. Even the operation theaters are not that clean. Provide the body an opportunity to fight. Maintain a balance between your environment and the body, because body is part of the environment. Do not use chemicals on the body. None of the chemicals are required. We are not evolved to tolerate the chemicals. If you really want to enhance the looks of the body, use something natural. Potatoes, oranges, lemon, whatever you find around, turmeric. Use the natural agents to enhance the look. Don't do makeup. Don't just buy whatever they show on the TV. It's not really required. The natural beauty is the best beauty. Something artificial means that you are trying to be something which you are not, and it is going to cause long-term problems. Like, you want a good rich husband, and so you want to look good, and you do makeup for 3 hours before meeting that person. The person marries you, but if he takes a look at you next day, he goes straight to the divorce lawyer. This has happened many times. True story. Don't show off. If you are ugly, just improve the other aspects of your life. Become an artist, become something useful so that you don't have to depend on your face or your nose to be acceptable in the society. What do you mean by acceptable? All these idiots, if they don't accept you, how is that a loss? You accept yourself. That is more than enough. Nobody is ugly. Nobody is beautiful. It is all in the mind. Remember that to a monkey, the female monkey looks like an angel. Same thing. It is all created in the mind. What you want is a clean and fit body, not a body which looks like a fashion model, because you know those models are all photoshopped pictures. Their job is to sell the magazine by invoking your inferiority complex, by invoking the unnatural urges in you. You never become like the model on the cover of the magazine. Probably you'll waste a lot of money, a lot of your life, a lot of your time doing that, feeling bad about yourself. Plus, your money goes in their pocket. Just look at the picture, enjoy the fake beauty there, and throw off the magazine. Better to use it as toilet paper. That is what the fashion magazine is worth. Do not make holes in your body. The ones that are already there are sufficient. And do not hang metal or stones in that. That is idiotic. Remember, this is the path of knowledge. We do not waste time in politically correct discussion. We simply say it. If you don't like it, don't listen. Keep doing whatever you're doing. This discussion is for seekers. They want to know what I'm doing wrong. That is what is being told. It is not an insult to anybody. I've done this all my life myself without knowing what I'm doing. Now, I don't know whether I should laugh on it or whether I should cry about it. Fix your food habits. Eat the most natural food that you can find, if you can find it. Cook your own food. Don't let other people touch your food. Don't eat the food cooked by others as far as possible. Yes, you can eat the biscuits and things like that because they're dry, chocolates and stuff. But if something is wet and if it is handled by others, do not eat it. Do not eat restaurant food. Eat at home. You will save a lot of money also. And avoid factory-made food. Avoid something that is mass-produced. Do not overeat. We do not live to eat. We eat to live. The food should be easy to digest, easy to excrete. It should have all the nutrients. Do not kill animals. Do not eat their dead bodies. That is not really required. If it is required, it will happen automatically. If you are in a place where there's plenty of human food, you eat that food first. Prefer that. Yes, if you live in a desert or Antarctica or somewhere where nothing grows, then you don't have any options. Your food should be according to your spiritual practice. If your teacher has told you that this kind of food is required for this kind of practice, stick to that food. Otherwise, you'll waste many years of your life because the practice is ineffective because you don't know the correct kind of food. Do not eat anything to which you are allergic to, your body cannot tolerate. Drink only water, nothing else. If you don't like water, drink fruit juices. Avoid sugar, avoid carbonized waters, avoid chemical soups. Even if they look very nice on the TV, let them be on the TV. Let your favorite actor drink it. They deserve it. Do not drink alcohol. Give up all the addictions. Live in an open environment where the air is flowing, where there's fresh air. Do not sleep too much. Do not sleep too less. Sleep at the right time. Fix your defecation. Make it a very, very simple and good ritual which you enjoy. It should not be done in a hurry and it should not be done in an irregular way. Most of our health depends on defecation. Exercise when you are young, rest when you are old. Sit in a good posture. Actually, there is no good posture. The most natural posture for the body is movement. The body is not designed to sit for 8 to 10 hours. The body is designed to change posture every few minutes. Look at the body. Even if it is sleeping, it changes the posture. So make a healthy habit to get up every now and then. Walk around. Sometimes you should sit. Sometimes you should lie down. Sometimes you should walk and run. Of course, the so-called modern lifestyle will not allow you. So you will need to change your lifestyle a little bit. Keep changing the posture. Keep stretching the body. This is how it has evolved. Now you will need to adjust. You will need to compromise. Yes, you want to do that job 10 hours straight, but it's kind of, the payback is extreme. You are not going to like your paycheck. If there is a disease in the body, treat it immediately by any means. Do not delay the treatment of the diseases. If there is a deformation, probably nothing can be done about it. You will need to get around it. Do not think of deformation as a lack. Think of it as a challenge. Now it is no more impurity. It is possible to live with a deformation. It's not that your whole life is now a waste. It is possible to make use of a deformed body also, a disabled body also. Don't make your old age into a joke by pretending to be young. There is nothing wrong in being old. And there is everything wrong in faking youth. It is a joke. The joke is on you. People are actually laughing behind your back. You think, I'm getting a lot of respect because I look young. No, you are a joke for others. This is especially true for women. They cannot let go of their golden age when everybody was running after them because they were so young and pretty. They delude themselves in thinking that they are the same, even at the age of 50, 60, 70. They become a laughing matter for others. You need to age gracefully, change your behavior with the age. And you must because the body has changed. Now you cannot be sexy. Change your role to something else which people respect. Become a teacher. Become a helper. Become a good cook. There are more ways and probably better ways to earn respect other than simply looking sexy. Do you think you get respect by looking in a specific way? No. If you are young, people drool after you, they lust after you. If you are old, they simply laugh at you. Our roles, they need to change as we age. There is no insult in becoming weak. There is no insult in having white hair. If somebody else is behaving with you in a specific way, only because you have silver hair instead of golden hair, or whatever color it is, and the problem is there. It is their problem, not yours. The mental retardation is in the other person who is taking a look at your hair to decide how to behave with this human. You are still a human. They have lost their humanity, not your problem. Do not try to conform to that moron there who is trying to impose their self-made standards on you. You are grown up. You are mature. Is it worth it? Is it worth becoming a puppet of some idiotic teenager? Oh, nobody respects me because I am old. You don't deserve that respect. That's why they don't respect you. The respect needs to be earned. You cannot simply color your hair and expect others to respect you. That is stupidity. Do something valuable. Become something. The respect needs to be earned. You will get more respect in the old age, not in the young. In the young age, you get either infatuation or jealousy. Now, I'm not saying all the young people are like this. No, they are not. But the old people who modify their natural behavior to please these 1% low lives, and that is a problem. That is the impurity there. When the body starts becoming old, you need to adapt to the body, change your eating habits. The defenses will be down, so you will need to be extra careful. And there will be loss of intellect. You will need help. Sometimes you will leave the tap on. Sometimes you will leave the heater on. Sometimes you will leave the burner on in your kitchen and so on. This will start happening. Sometimes you will miss your medicines and so on. So you will need help. Be prepared for that time. When the body says goodbye, you also need to say goodbye. Don't beg to the body to stay. The body is packing up, you also pack up. This is the rational behavior. This is the intelligent behavior. There is no impurity here. Stay away from other people. Do not expose yourself to hundreds of people. Do not take on their habits without thinking. Do not go too close to people. All you will get is their diseases. Do not shake hands. That is not bad manners. That is stupid manners. You can show your respect and love in other ways. You don't have to hold their hand, which they have never washed in their lives. And you can be very respectful also. Do not engage in crime. Do not kill people. Do not go on wars. The job of a soldier is the filthiest job in the universe. Somebody else is using you to kill other people, innocent people. If you are violent, channel your violence into something else. Kill the politician instead. Kill the military leader that is using you as a weapon. Do not engage in risky behavior that can cause harm to the body. The more you do it, the more degradation there is in the body. If you like to drive very fast, do it in a desert. Kill yourself, don't kill others. The bodies of the others are important. If you think my body is not important, speed is important somehow. If you are incapable of deriving entertainment out of simple, beautiful adventures, then go and do it alone. Do not put others at risk. Cultivate this habit of being satisfied with the natural limits of the body. Yes, some people are very capable. They can do extraordinary things. They have developed this kind of ability, but they pay for it later. If you like risk, the spiritual path is not for you. On the spiritual path, we protect the body. We do not put it on a metal box running at 200 kilometers per hour, on a track on which all kinds of lunatics are driving already. There is no end to how much corrections you can do in your body. What are the advantages of purification of the body? The body becomes fit and healthy, beautiful, it glows, it smells good, you feel very light. It is effortless. Whatever you do becomes successful because you have the energy now. The body is not defending itself. The body is not in a war mode. There is no need to kill the ecosystem. You can survive with all the germs and bacteria, no problem at all. You must have noticed that if the body is healthy, you will be happy without any reason. If the body is sick, even a truckload of gold is not going to make you happy. There is a natural beauty in the body. It looks beautiful even if it is old. You are old and ugly because of the sins of the youth, not because the body is like this. If the body is fit, you sleep better and your intelligence will grow. You will be able to do the same job in half the time. You will commit less errors. You will know exactly what to do, when to do. If your defecation is right, you will never feel your stomach. If your food is right, you will never feel any kind of heaviness, laziness in the body. It is very natural for the body to be excited all the time. It is very natural for the body to move swiftly. It likes to dance. Because of the burden of the impurities, it can barely move. You can do any exercise in the world, any yoga poses, any kind of meditation will come easily to you if the body is pure. You will find that even your speech becomes pure, sweet, and you will find that your thoughts, they reflect the body. Remember, it's all connected. All these layers are connected. It will live for a long time if you don't engage in risky behavior. There won't be any kind of fear because you are not a soldier or you're not a criminal. Even with disability or deformation or some kind of disease, you will find that still you are left with a lot of energy and time to do your spiritual work, to study or to meditate, to attend the satsang, to watch the videos like this. Your attention will become very strong, very steady, because the body has no pains. The body has no itches or scratches in it. A really healthy body is that which you don't even feel there is a body. The body disappears when it is very healthy. I think everybody knows this, but we have forgotten it somehow. Why? I want pleasure. That's why. That's why I'm torturing this body. That's why I'm acting retarded, because I'm superior. And the cost is, you've wasted the most beautiful and complex machine in this universe. The body is not only a very good vehicle, it is our temple. It looks like that I'm living in this body, isn't it? Why would you do such things to your home? I can guarantee you that with a pure body, you won't even need to progress spiritually. You won't need to do any kind of effort. You will progress automatically. This has been arranged like this. Why does it not happen? Why don't people progress naturally, spiritually? The realization that I am not the body and it is an experience that comes and goes. And the detachment with the body. It all must happen naturally. But it does not happen. The reason is ignorance. Most of this poison is coming from the society. Most of it is indoctrination. Most of it is mental degradation of some kind. This is not your natural state. Our natural state is a divine being using a body in an illusory dream. Look what has happened. Sit down and look at the body. Fix it. Enjoy it. There is nothing wrong in a human birth. If you use it wisely, It's a beautiful body. It's a useful thing. This is the only instrument that we have for any kind of experience. Without experience, we are not going to progress even one inch.